those Dakota Lithium batteries in, and I had some inadequate wires in here, so putting some wires in, number one. But number two, these batteries have so much capacity, I decided that we were going to do something unique to it, and we're going to add an inverter. And the reason why we're going to add an inverter, you can back up, is because we live in Florida, and sometimes, you know, we have power outages for hurricanes or whatnot. And so I decided I'm just going to do an experiment. We bought this off of Amazon. There wasn't very many reviews, you know, as you see. So here's the company. I don't know, whatever that company is, Chinese company. But you can get these inverters in 12, 24, 36, 48, 60, 72. I mean, they will make one for whatever you want. So how good this thing is, I don't know. It actually has a remote control. Shows one of these is input voltage, one of these is output voltage, has a switch, and then it has a remote control that you can turn on. So we're going to hook this up to the battery pack. We're going to mount it behind the seat, have these plugs available so that we can, two things. Number one, if the power goes out for a short period and all we want to do is maybe make sure our refrigerator, you know, doesn't get warm and spoil all the food in there, we'll just drag out an extension cord and use this. Once this is installed, I'm going to do an experiment and see how much, you know, how much amperage the refrigerator draws and if it'll work or not. Because I have no idea. I really didn't see any reviews on doing this off a golf cart. I have this Renogy meter right here, which is not hooked up. Well, it's not running because I have the batteries disconnected. But so when the inverter is on, it's going to go through the shunt. That's the shunt, and that's hooked up to the Renogy meter. And so when you actually have the power coming from that side and going to the inverter, you'll be able to see what the refrigerator draws. And this has some calculations on it, and it'll tell you how long you'll be able to run the refrigerator. So the second thing is, once this inverter is hooked up, now we have a portable 110 volt electric station. We will experiment what can be run off of this inverter, so how good it is. All right, so the inverter is installed. Let's take a look at it. There's the panel. I just got a piece of wood, painted it, mounted it on there, painted it black, and figured I didn't want to mount it down below because water intrusion. There is water in the bottom, so I wanted to keep it semi-safe from rain and water. And it's fully charged right now. There's 0 amps, 0 watts transferring either way. Oops, there we go. Okay, so it works. Okay, so 43 volts in, 123 out. The monitor is now awake. So with the inverter just on, this is a 1200 watt heat gun. Okay, so let's see what we're pulling. 14 amps, 600 watts. And it is getting hot. So with this heat gun on at drawing 14.7 amps or 600 watts, looks like we can go about 6 hours and 44 minutes. Let's go to high power, and this should be 1200 watts. So about 2 hours and probably settle around 2 hours and 50 minutes. Pulling a continuous 34 amps, 1300 watts. So I think that's pretty damn impressive. Next test is to try a refrigerator. Let's see here. Pretty damn cool. I like it. Okay, we're just going to try the inverter on this small fridge to start with. Right now I have the fridge turned to off. Inverter. Again, the inverter pulls 7 watts. Let's plug this thing in. Let's see what... Actually, I got the fridge off, so I'll have to go turn it on. Kick this thing on. Yeah, it's running. So, this thing's on max cold. It's just a little, you know, dorm fridge or whatever. Pulling only 152 watts. 3.67 amps. This 1500 watt, 3000 max inverter running off the Dakota 36 volt pack easily runs a dorm fridge.
no problem, and it will run it for 27 hours. So but it'll be more than 27 hours because the fridge cycles on and off. I bet you could get 30 hours out of it, so day and a half. Just proof of concept that you can install a 36 volt inverter. There's the Dakota pack. Maybe we'll just put a big TV in it, the beer fridge on the back, and drive around and watch the Bucks beat Kansas City this weekend, this Sunday. So, all right, time to go. See you guys.